So let's just begin gisting, because the class is just all about, we'll just gist tonight.
Okay, sir. Let's just see your face, because...
Okay, my face, bar.
Yes, we can see your face and hear your voice, instead of the PowerPoint.
It's good like that.
All right, sir.
All right, so good evening, everybody.
Good evening, sir. Please mute your mic.
Good evening, sir.
All done. So, as a issue of introduction, my name is Tewa Setwange. We're just going to be having a second section of the class we had earlier last week Sunday, and then we couldn't finish because of time. So I just want to briefly, we're going to discuss about the investment opportunities that exist around agriculture, because that is my space. I'm working currently with a company called Effex Commodities Exchange. I'm the warehouse manager over here, and then we'll deal with commodities. We major basically in agriculture. So I'm going to be sharing part of our experience and how each and every one of us can make money, right, from agriculture in general. So, but as an issue of recap for those that were not here last week, we talked about investment, and I don't want to use big grammars, but investment basically is just a way to generate passive income. For instance, let's say, I saw a land in Abuja, and the aim of me buying this land is that in the future, it will appreciate in price so that I can sell it. Are you getting it? To make more money. Or I can, you know, build structures or needs for people to rent. I'm investing already. I'm ready investment. Let's say Bro Shedrack here saw one sister in the Lord in fellowship and RCF, or you saw one sister in this local assembly. And then he met the sister and told the sister, he says, see, oh, this is what God is saying. Oh, I've been praying. I'm tired of being single. I want to change levels. And then, you know, the sister said, hey, let's see how it is going. Are you getting me? Let's see how it will go. And then Bro Shedrack started buying Richard card. Buy meat pie. Bro Shedrack, buy yogurt. The sister will say, I don't have clothes. He will wire 50,000 to her. Say, go to boutique. Change your wardrobe. All those things Bro Shedrack is doing, he's investing. The aim is at the end of the day, he wants to carry his sister to go and marry.
Amen.
And carry him to the house. So Bro Shedrack is an investment.
Yes,
he's investing. You understand? So investments are in different opportunities. Yes, that's why sometimes you notice, for instance, let's say this Bro Shedrack incident now. Let's say at the end of the day, the sister came and said, no, I no go agree. I no go agree. At the end of the day, there's a way Bro Shedrack will feel. Right? It's the same way Bro Shedrack feels, that heartbreak he feels. It's the same heartbreak people that are into stocks feel when their stock plummets. When Bitcoin was high, people were happy, people were jumping. The moment Bitcoin, Ethereum, and all those other coins began to drop down, you notice people were... People started calling their investors, people that brought them into Bitcoin, and they were angry. They were feeling bad. Most people felt very bad. Are you getting me? Because of the fact that, you know, the investment is spoiling. So it's the same thing with investment generally means, for instance, I see an opportunity and I want to generate, let's say, a passive income. And I invest in this opportunity because of what I can stand to gain in the future. And what I'm standing to gain is positive returns, higher returns than what maybe I'm putting initially. That is, I'm ready investment. So investment is very simple. And I remember last week we were talking about the types of investment. You know, we talked about stocks. Stocks simply means some companies, sometimes they want to execute projects, right? They want to execute a plan. You know, they don't have the finance. They don't want to go to bank to get the money. Simply what happens is that the company begins to share, sell stocks. Are you getting me? Some companies, when they're even beginning, they do something that looks like a crowdfunding. They call it all pre-IPO. You can, you know, go and buy allotment units, buy shares before it goes to the stock market. Are you getting me? But the simple way you make money from stocks are very simple, is that by the time maybe you buy a unit of shares from UBA Bank for 2,500. Are you getting me? And let's say you have the shares and all that, but then little later I notice it has increased to, let's say, 5,000 naira, you will sell. But I want to advise you, I beg of you, I'm not against investing in Nigerian-based companies, but if you are investing in stocks, because stocks is volatile. Let's say I'm the CEO of a company, UBA, and I resign, or for instance, I die and my son takes over, if my son doesn't have sense and he used the money for womanizing, use it to travel abroad and all that, your stocks, and let's say the company's performance is very poor at the end of the day, your dividends will be very poor overall. You get. So what I'm saying in a nutshell is that I'm not discouraging you investing in Nigerian companies, but invest after you've done your investigation. Okay, who is the leaders of this company? Who is the board? What is their history of success like? What is their financial statement and all that? Because your stocks, how well your stock performs depends on the performance of the company. I remember also we talked about, you know, bonds. Bonds is basically you, you know, giving permission to the government or giving permission to, let's say, a business entity to, you know, borrow money from you. At the end of the day, they'll give you with interest in your investment. Federal government bonds are usually more safer. And then I remember also we talked about, apart from that, we talked about mutual funds. We talked about exchange, that is ETFs, that is exchange traded funds. We talked about options. All these are ways, and there are applications online. Currently, right now, you can use basically to invest. Let's say you want to buy shares in a company, a foreign company, and all that, you know, you can just go online, go to the Play Store, you can download an app. They call it Bamboo app. You can download an app. I think there's one they call Trevor. There's one they call Chaka. You can download all these apps. Chaka. Bamboo is the same. Boo. Then there are other ones. Trivia, they are there. Those applications can help you assess international stock markets. Some of them will require you to put your NIN number and some other things just for verification to know that you are a real human being. But then also, I remember that last time when we had the last class, and we're discussing, I said emphatically clear that before you invest in a stock or before you carry your money, you know, these days, everybody wants to hammer, everybody wants to make it big. Everybody wants to go to Lekki, they want to be in Maitama, they want to, you understand, they want to drive bears. And so any small thing, any small investment that we, you tell them, okay, there's an opportunity without doing due investigation. You see people rushing to put your money. Please, I want to beg. You know, I've heard people that have invested. It's just like, for instance, even me or Shedrack, for instance, as I used earlier. Shedrack sees a babe, for instance, and then he has not done investigation. For it, question number one, does this girl have sense? Question number two, what is her genotype? Question number three, what is her plan for his life? And Shedrack just went without doing investigation. I'm going to be spending money, be sending 100,000. You understand? You said, Kwasi do ashe. You spend money. She needs this one. You spend. It's poor investment. So what our advice is this. Before you invest your hard-earned money on anything, you must be very careful to do investigation. Don't be lazy. Go online. Check. Be careful. Check what this company is all about. Who are the people in charge of the company and all that. But regarding investment, right? You must be very careful because as you are trying to invest to make money for yourself, there are a lot of people that are out there already in the market. They are scammers. They are out there to deceive you, to carry your money. I told somebody, I said, remember those days when I was finishing YC service now, you know that time? We just came back from service and everybody's blood was hot. I wanted to do quick and build house also in Lekki or get money. You understand? So I wanted to invest. I saved my money under the sun and in the rain, my sweat. I saved money. You know, I was at home one day and I got an international call. I want after this video, maybe you take out time, but go to YouTube and watch some of these videos on some of these Indian scammers. You know, Nigeria was still the elementary stage of scamming. Those guys have gone advanced. The people that called me, if you go online, there's an app they call, what they call that, a U-Banker app. If you check Play Store, you will see them. Anywhere you hear of that app, running away, they are fraudsters. But if you check under the comment section, you know, people that are giving the app stars, they are fellow fraudsters. You give 5 stars, say best app, investment at a go. And then you are there, you are running, you are not the investigation. You will fall victim. They called me and they told me of my investment opportunity. I, you know, as a normal Nigerian looking to invest, I was excited. I was like, wow, you know, I was about to jump into the opportunity. They said the minimum was already 150,000 naira. And if you are a copper, you will know what it takes you to save up to, even 50,000 before your POP, not to talk about 150. That was a huge sum of money. But because of I wanted to invest, now they're telling me returns on investment in dollars, I'm going to get this back and all that. I was nearly scammed. But thank God for my younger brother that came and delivered me from the spirit of foolishness. You know, by now, they'll be crying. So one of the things you must watch out before you invest your money, I will run through them again. We've gone through this in the last class. But as I said in the last class, you must have clear communication about the investment options. You understand? Do not invest in what you don't understand. Ask yourself a question. How does this investment, for instance, earn returns? How sustainable is the process? Is it a process that has a structure? I don't know if you're understanding me. You must be very careful, because as you're even browsing the internet, sometimes you see some sponsors ad. They are telling you to buy shares, training to invest and all that. If you are not careful, you will carry your hard-earned money. You are in the office Monday afternoon. You were hungry. You were sitting down on your chair. Are you getting me? One oga came and shouted you, but you kept quiet. You wanted to reply, but you kept quiet. Oh, no, my salary at the end of the month is what I'm here for. And if you are not careful, after all that stuff ahead, are you getting me? All the struggles and all that, you will dash money to one scammer. So be very careful. Are you getting me? Be very careful. Understand, be clear. Communication. Even if somebody is trying to sell you an investment idea, even if the person is your friend or your parent, calm the person. Let the person not be in a rush. You did not rush to make the money. So let the person explain to you. The second thing is that you must, you know, ask yourself, is this investment opportunity, right, strictly driven by referrals? I don't know if you're understanding me. Ask yourself that question. Is this investment opportunity strictly driven by referrals? There are a lot of people now that will tell you, see, don't get me wrong, we're in a connected economy. Everybody, you know, you must refer somebody to refer somebody. But see, if it's strictly driven by referral, for me, that is a red flag. Are you getting me? Because what happens in some of this referral system is that the process is not sustainable. They are using the new members coming in, their money to pay you. I don't know if you're understanding me. So by the time you know you are there, you know, you are just thinking you are making money. Like for instance, they'll tell you, bring two people. Then they'll balance the left-hand side, balance the right-hand side. I don't want to call some of those investment opportunities. They may call police for me, but you know what I'm talking about. All those ones that are strictly referrals, be very careful. It's not that easy. If it were easy, most of them would have become billionaire. The person even advertising it for you. Are you getting me? Look at their shoes sometimes. You should be able to know by the shoes. Like, come on, look down. You see the shoes is anyhow. Are you getting me? So be very careful. Do not just throw your money like that. Secondly, ask yourself, is the investment platform regulated? Are they signed up to the Securities and Exchange Commission? Is it something that just popped up? And then they'll tell you, bring friends. So, you know, it's on WhatsApp group. The office of the company starts and ends with WhatsApp group. So the moment the admin leaves the WhatsApp group, the business has ended. Be very careful. Are you getting me? I've heard a lot. I was in my room one of those days when something happened and one of my friends lost a lot of money. It was just a WhatsApp group structure. There is no regulation anywhere. Mm-mm. The moment the man of God, the scammer, left the group, but it was using Bible verse for them. You know, there are a lot of people right now, they are scamming you, but they scam you in the name of the Lord. They scam you with scriptures. So he was that kind of scammer. The moment the chairman left the group, that was the end. See, now those people have not gotten back their money. So ask yourself, is this investment platform regulated? Do not rush. Secondly, thirdly, ask yourself, right? This investment platform, what are they guaranteeing? There are some of this investment platform that will come and meet you and say, see, and they tell you something. Invest. As bad as it bad, your investment money, you will get them. Even if the investment spoil, you don't go lose your initial money. Anybody coming to tell you that stuff, be very careful. Most of the times, right, they are there to scam you. Because even in stocks and bonds that you buy, legitimately, they don't give you guarantee paybacks. So any platform telling you guarantee paybacks, there is no losses, there's one robot that we have designed. The robot is checking the stock market, and if it sees losses, it will run away from the loss, run away from that person. Are you getting me? It may be your friend, though. Try to educate the person, but if the person is not listening, run away. Investment opportunities will not run. They are still coming every day. Then you ask yourself, lastly, double-digit returns. You know, there are some of these investments that will tell you that, what do you call it again, that invest now, 30% return on investment every month. Are you getting me? 30% return on investment every month. Some people will tell you 200%. You bring 50,000, you get 100,000. How is the 100,000 coming? They will not explain. Are you getting me? Any investment opportunity that is too good to be true, most of the times is actually too good to be true. Most of the time it's a scammer that is trying to scam you. So be very careful. And then I remember the last week or so, before we dive into agriculture very briefly so that we can all dismiss, we talked about investment opportunity in Nigeria. And I was telling people, I said, there's bank investment. If you, apart from the stock, now the stocks and the bonds, ETFs, mutual funds, you know, all those ones are available to everybody. I don't know if you're understanding me, they're available to all of us. But then coming down to Nigeria, the investment opportunity that are available to us in Nigeria, you can invest in your bank. Bank investment is there, right? Some of the bank investment, they'll promise you 10 to 15%, you know, annual return on investment and all that. You can invest in cryptocurrency, but frankly, I don't know how crypto markets actually really works. I'm still understanding the market, still trying to understand what is it. But I have Ethereum per se, but I'm still understanding it. But we have real estate. Real estate is the sense that you have an uncle, you have an auntie, God bless you, you have money. There are big towns like Port Harcourt, big towns that things are happening. Are you getting me? Like Lagos, like Abuja. You can go and either buy rundown buildings and is trying to encourage, the government is trying to bring people in, you know, partner with private sector, you know, to try to boost the productivity of the farmers, because food security is very important. Everybody eats food, including the rich man. And also the fact that agriculture is a way to generate income. About agriculture, I'm not talking about the old picture of agriculture that was not enticing that you had growing up as a child, whereby, you know, as we all know, village people, you carry your wife, you go to the farm, and then you guys are using crude equipment, you know, the inside sun and all that. Agriculture have advanced past that stage. You can actually rent machineries right now. If you are in a state, for instance, like, let's say, Lafia, Nasarawa State, you can go to the ministry, go to the Ministry of Agriculture. At there are tractors there, you can rent. I think there are some states, the farmer. So for me, agriculture, be it livestock, be it the normal cultivation, is one of the best investments in Nigeria. It's one of the best. And to be honest with you, the trend shows that because of, you know, the Fulani crisis, the problems in the north and all that, and people are running away from their everybody hear me? All right.
Yes, sir. Sorry
so
for
the
that,
trend
sir.
Shows that. All right, no problem. The trend shows that they've taken light at my end, but the trends in Nigeria now shows that the issue of food security is not going to be like, for instance, let's say there was 10,000 metric tons of soya beans in the market this year. Because of the issue of the insecurity, there's going to be less. Are you getting me? Because most people are running away from their farms. So agriculture is something, as every Nigerian, as every youth, to be frank with you, if you're not thinking agriculture, you've not started thinking investment, because I'm going to explain very soon for you. And then, you know, apart from agriculture, also you can invest in transportation services. There are places right now, they have banned Okada. They have banned Keke Napep, or banned certain means of transportation. You can actually, if you have the money, right, you can actually buy some of these vehicles, convey people. There are people, they have the money. It's so painful. I have a friend that is staying very far. If you know Makodi very well, industrial layout, that is Naka, mobile police access there. And, you know, he say even with his money, he struggles to get to where he wants to go. So you have the means, and God has blessed you. You can get some of these motor vehicles, put put them on the road in the hands of competent drivers. I won't be telling you stories every day. And then you can be getting money from that recreational center also. We need it. There are a lot of people, even me myself, frankly, Makodi is summarized for me. I told one of my friends that very not too long ago. If you go to some of these other states, you have a lot of places you can go at the end of the day to relax, you know, to chill, to there's a children park where your children are playing. There are places where you can have PS3, PS4 with your friends. You sit down to cool off. There's swimming pool. There are all these relaxation points, amazing sceneries with amazing restaurants. And people with their money are willing to pay thousands, 15,000 for a plate of food. It's not the food, it's the scenery. They just want to relax and know that, yes, they are not doing that bad. They just want to cool off. Are you getting me? So if you have the money, you can build some of those structures. What happens is that some of the times, after you even build them, you can build small, small stores and small, small stands. So the suya man out there can come in and pay rent and have a structure for himself. The person that is doing cooking, that can do fish very well, can come, rent a store. So you are making a lot of money. So that is another way to, you know, another area to look about. But now let's talk very briefly on agriculture. Now, one of the things you must notice about Nigeria, first of all, is that God has blessed us. We don't have earthquake. We don't have volcano. We don't have some of these other natural disasters that, you know, other countries are experiencing. In fact, the average Nigerian land, if you put egusi, or you put maize and you put fertilizer, or sometimes even without fertilizer, they tend to do well. Nigeria, we are blessed with large expanse of arable lands, large expanse of fertile soil, right? And the agricultural sector is a sector in this country that is developing. If you check right now, there are a lot of processing factories being set up. In Makurdi, there's one cassava factory that they are setting up. And right now, almost every farmer is like the rang and alarm. Every farmer is now farming cassava, even me. We are now in the farm. Are you getting me? We are chucking cassava stem because there's one factory. There are other people that it is rice that they farm. There are other individuals you can decide soya beans. But one of the things I want to let you know is that the Nigerian land is blessed. Are you getting me? And there is no way you can invest in agriculture except you don't know what you are doing, that you will not make or you will not break even. It's very difficult. Let's say maybe a self act of God, like maybe lack of rainfall, rapid pest infestation, or let's say there's a viral infection on your farm and you fail to, let's say, remove the infected plant and it spread. But it's very difficult for somebody, an individual, not to make your production cost, not to get it back at the end of the day. I don't know if you're understanding me. Now, by agriculture, this is what I mean. Let's say, for instance, right now, Mr. Shedrack has 15 million naira. Mr. Shedrack can go and meet the state government. Amen. In the states. Amen. It will happen. Mr. Shedrack can go and meet the state government and say, see, I want to go into agriculture and I need land. There are lands that are reserved that the states have. Are you getting me? And you know, those lands are stretching to hectares upon hectares. So you can pay amount of money. Are you getting me? For the land, or you can go to all these people that farm, pay amount of money, get, let's say, 10 hectares. And then you bring a machinery in. You pay those guys, they are not expensive, especially depending on when you approach them. There are times in which they are work, they have plenty work on their hand. So by the time you meet them there, they'll be calling 5 million or 20 million or calling huge amount of money for you. Not up to millions, quite all right, I was joking. But they'll call a huge sum for you. But there are seasons whereby you can make, you know, meet them and tell them, okay, see, that's beginning. You don't come when the rain has started. Let's say after the first rain, you can begin to make your contact. After the first rain or the second rain, you can meet them, hire them, pay them money. They open the land for you. Are you getting me? I'm trying to give you a classical investment idea on agriculture, how you can make your money back. Let's say they open the land and then you wait a little bit to notice that, okay, yeah, the rain is now steady. Then you go and plant. You pay people. They plant for you. Very, very quick process. And then you go home. Are you getting me? You come back later. You apply fertilizer for maximum productivity. Your aim is to get plenty money back. You don't want to get small money. Now, by the time you do that, and let's say the clearing stage comes, and then you take your team and you go and then let's say you clear the land, you know, remove the weed so that the competition for the available nutrients will be less, and then you harvest, right? One of the things I will advise you to do is that immediately after you harvest, do not take your goods straight to the market, except maybe there's pressing need. You see, the truth of the matter is that at harvest periods, the prices of these commodities are not too encouraging. A bag of soya beans, let's say, you know, can go for give or take, let's say, 15,000 naira. But when you leave the same soya beans, let's say for 2 months, 1 month, 3 months, the price will appreciate in value. That is the investment. Just like the way you buy land, and over time you leave the land, and the land that was nothing before, before you know, it appreciates in value. It's the same thing with agricultural products. You get your goods, you back them very well, you find like a storage structure, maybe a small store in your house, or a small room nobody is using. Are you getting me? You can tell your dad, daddy, wait to, I have goods, so let's use this room. And then you put your goods there. I don't know if you're understanding me. You leave it 1, 2, 3 months. As you leave it, it just be looking at the price of the market. It is appreciating. Maybe it reaches the point where you say, okay, I want to sell. You can take it out and sell. You have invested in agriculture. You put in 50,000. At the end of the day, you discover you are making close to 100,000, 150,000, sometimes even 500,000 naira from something you put in little. Are you getting me? So I want to encourage you basically that if you are the type that maybe let's say you are not even gifted, you say, okay, I don't know how to farm, and I want to make money from agriculture. One of the things I advise you to do is this. They are cooperative, farming cooperative. There are people that will know how to farm, but they are looking for money. In the village, there's something they used to do, whereby I can give you one bag of soya beans. At harvest season, you can give me 3 bags or 2 bags. Are you getting me? There are farming cooperatives that know how to farm. They have the experience, but they don't have the money. You can join some of those cooperatives. You partner with some of them. They will go and farm for you. You guys will have the meetings and you know what is happening. They keep you up to speed. And at the end of the day, you discover you make your returns. I don't know if you understand me. It's a good investment. It's a good, very profitable investment. Agriculture is very profitable. You look at commodities like rice, the prices appreciate. Commodities like soya beans, the prices appreciate. So my encouragement to you this night is, if you're not the type that have thought about farming yet, I want to encourage you. It's not too late. The rains have just... started. You can still plant soya beans and engage in agriculture. Don't let this season pass you by. I don't know if you're understanding me. Do not let this season pass you by. Find a team. Find somebody that is already doing the business. If you cannot go in yourself, just connect with the right people. But this season, I want to encourage you, I want to advise you, because what we are seeing right now, there may be food shortage. If you cannot engage in agriculture right now, you know, it's good you start something when it is, you are still young. All of us here were young. So it's good you start it now so you understand how the market operates. If it's during dry season, for instance, there's what we call dry season farming. A basket of tomato right now, when it's the issue of, let's say, for instance, the normal harvest period after the rains, tomato in basket can go for 1,000 naira, 500 naira sometimes. But right now, a basket of tomato is 25,000 naira. So imagine you farm tomato, dry season. You'll be making your money. I don't know if you're understanding me. So the encouragement is that engage in agriculture. Find a team, find a cooperative. I work with a company, our company name is Apex. We have an application, they call the ComX application, right? You can download it online, ComX by Apex. How the application works is simple. You have the money. At the end of harvest season, you go there. You will see that, let's say, a bag of soya beans on the application is, let's say, 11,500. And you have the money to buy 100 bags. That's 11, or let's say, in millions. You buy the 100 bags and keep. You will be noticing it on the app. A point will come in where that same bag you buy for 11,500. Don't be afraid. The moment you buy the goods, right? The goods are in our warehouses. Somewhere in Nigeria, your 100 bags that you bought is actually 100 bags. So by the time you notice the price appreciation, let's say 11,500, you check the app the next time, you notice the price has increased to 20,000 naira, you can decide to sell it. Are you getting me? You have not found empowered farmers, and you receive returns on investment in your farming. So there are a lot of ways you can make money in agriculture, a lot of ways, and it pays faster. So with the way with agriculture, if EFCC comes knocking, you can explain. Are you getting me? So you can either go into agriculture in terms of the farming, or you can go into livestock production. Any one of them pays. You can go into chicken, you can rear goats, you can whatever it is, but don't go into something you have no prior knowledge about. Before you start livestock, it's very advisable. You go and learn under people that are into the business, other people that have been rearing chickens, for instance. Let's say it's chicken that you want to rear. Other people that have been doing one or two things so that you learn from experience, so you will not suffer a lot of damages. So, but the advice this night, lastly, is that investment is very good. It's a way to generate passive income. You are not sweating. You are sleeping, you know, and you are making money. It's the way Warren Buffett made it. Think rich people these days think investment. They think smart. Are you getting me? So I want to encourage all of us to think smart, think investment. You can check some of those applications online. One of them, the Bamboo application, Babo application. By the time you even download and install it, it comes with a manual to help you understand how the stock market works. So when you have money, please don't carry everything and go and spend. I know sometimes it's, you know, you there's this spirit of I can't come and go and kill myself. But sometimes save something, I get to be invest somewhere. So at the end of the day, even while you are sleeping, passive income, you are generating wealth. A time can come, depending on how much investment you have in your portfolio. You can retire early and you have no fear. No boss somewhere can be threatening your life. Are you getting me? You'll become a boss on your own. So think investment, think agriculture. And I think I've done for this evening tonight. If there's any question, I believe we can take it over to the group chat. Thank you very much, Shashadrak. I appreciate you. And thank you everybody for giving me your time. Okay. No,
so, want to see our faces.
Okay, very important. Please, so on your videos, so let's see our faces. Everybody. So where are the other people? Are they still around?
Some people had to go because of network challenge. They have been messaging me. But the good thing is that we have the class recorded. They can also follow
online.
All right.
Good evening, sir.
Great man. Appreciate you so much. So can you introduce yourself? Let's know who you are. Like your name.
Okay, good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
What you learned from the class. Good evening.
Yeah, we can hear you.
We can hear you.
I believe network has started again, though.
Okay. If not, we would have gotten to know him, what he learned, and all that. But if there are any questions, we can take it over, you know, to the WhatsApp class.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right, sir.
Priscilla and Peace. If you don't want to show your face, because I don't know ladies of nowadays, let us hear your voice.
They are shy. They are shy.
All right, sir.
And the Peace is very, very fine girl. Sister Peace. What did the Lord not say? All done. All right, so I hope sir. You learned something from the class, Peace.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you, sir. Peace, you have to all say right, something.
God bless you.
You have unmuted yourself finally.
So, Peace, we're hearing you. What do you want to say? Oh, Peace is busy with a child.
Today's
we're hearing you.
Yeah,
you're breaking. Let's take it over to the WhatsApp class.
Yes, sir.
Please,
yes,
go
sir.
To the WhatsApp class and just tell us your name, introduce yourself, and what you learned, and what you are planning on investing inside. Because we need to know what you people are going to invest in.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
God bless you. God bless you. I appreciate you. All right. God bless you all.
Good night.
All right. Good night.